Hare Krishna. To increase satisfaction, replace expectation with appreciation. All of us, at some time or the other in our life, feel dissatisfied. Sometimes this feeling is not just occasional, but it becomes perpetual. And dissatisfaction becomes like a nagging, tormenting, irritating, de-energizer and distractor that is always sucking our energy. And although sometimes dissatisfaction can act as a fuel for further commitment, further achievement, quite often dissatisfaction acts not as a spur but as a disheartener. Rather than giving us more energy, it takes away our energy by making us feel that we don't have enough things, whatever the particular things that maybe we feel lacking in our situation. Now, in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 17th chapter, Krishna talks about austerity of the body, the speech, and then of the mind. And in the austerity of the mind, he says, Manah prasada saumyattam maunam atma vinigraha bhava samshuddhiryetat tapomanasam uchyate. So he says, tapomanasam, among the austerities of the mind, one of them is Manah prasada. Manah prasada means cheerfulness of mind, satisfaction of the mind. And it's interesting, Krishna calls satisfaction of the mind as austerity. Now, austerity is not something which just happens to us. Oh, I'm feeling austere, I'm not feeling austere. We don't think of austerity in those terms. We think of austerity as a conscious choice, as an intentional decision. Okay, today I'll perform an austerity. Maybe I'll fast on Ekadashi or whatever the specific austerity might be. So like that, when we talk about austerity, it is a conscious choice. And when Krishna is saying that satisfaction of the mind is an austerity, then is a sort of satisfaction is an austerity of the mind. This means that he is referring to the point that satisfaction has to be a conscious choice. And the way we can become satisfied is by replacing expectation with appreciation. So expectation means, what am I going to get? What is going to happen to me? What way, how will things improve? Or what will become better? What will I gain more? So when we are in an expectant mode, then we are always focusing on what we don't have and what we will have or what we believe we should have. But quite often things don't work out the way we want, and then we don't get those things, and then we feel further dissatisfied because of that. So instead, if we focus on the point of satisfaction in terms of appreciation, we strive for satisfaction through appreciation. We look at what we have and appreciate what we have. So all of us have certain things, many things in fact. If we count our blessings, we'll find that there are a substantial number of things to count. We have health, we have some basic amenities. How many people don't? There are many people who don't have those things. And most of all, when we understand the spiritual wisdom of the Bhagavad Gita, we understand that we have Krishna in our heart. And He is our greatest well-wisher. And He loves us. And in His love, we can get the lasting satisfaction. And in His love lies the fulfillment of all our hearts longing for love. So by meditating on Krishna, by turning towards Krishna, by striving to love Krishna, we can actually gain lasting satisfaction. But Krishna is in our heart, rather than appreciating His presence. By appreciation, this doesn't mean that we value it, but we realize it. And we enhance our realization and our appreciation of the value of Krishna's presence. So suppose we have a jewel and we neglect it and we go around begging for things. That is, we don't appreciate the value of the jewel. So Krishna and the devotion to Him that can bring us lasting happiness is like a jewel. But unfortunately, we're not aware of the value of Krishna's presence. So we neglect it. So by replacing expectation, what will I get, with appreciation, what do I have? By replacing expectation with appreciation, we can raise our satisfaction. Thank you. Hare Krishna.